Hi Paul, thanks for watching. This is a bit of an unplanned live stream, so we're flying by the seat of our pants right now. Bit of a test, really.
Hi Paul, thanks for watching.
Oh, hang on. Bit of an echo going on. So I'm painting a 28mm Perry Miniatures French Napoleonic Infantryman. Not sure if I can get the focus to stick. We'll just see how it goes. Definitely going to take some getting used to painting from behind a camera again. See, I've already got it on the gun there. So for the blue jacket, I'm going to give it a base coat of Scale 75. Deep blue. Just going to water it down slightly. See, we got 10 viewers at the moment, that's cool. Yeah, apologies if the camera is going in and out of focus. I'm not sure if I've got control over that at the moment. So, how's everyone doing today? Hope you've had a productive day of painting. Hi, Bob from Canada. So I'm going to give him some nice off-white trousers. I'm going to start with light mud. Hi Peter, thanks for the comment. This is kind of a test live stream, so we're just going to see how this one goes. If it turns out alright, we might make it available to watch afterwards. I think in the future we might want to use a different setup so we can have more control over the focus. Okay. I think I'll undercoat the shako cover next. So I'm going to use Vallejo Dark Mud. This is another Panzer Aces colour. So we're going to be washing the flesh with a brown wash in a minute, but before I do that I'm going to take some Vallejo Beige Brown and I'm going to paint over the backpack, because that's going to have a brown wash as well, so we can all do it at the same time. Not really being too precious about straps or anything at the moment, as those are going to be undercoated later anyway. Okay, there we go. So I'm going to do the wood next. So we're going to use Vallejo flat brown. Nice red brown, this. Good base coat for a sort of medium wood colour. Pretty empty, this paint. Can we get any out? Oh, it's tense. Nearly. Come on. There we go. Might as well throw that one away. All right. Wore it down a smidge. So what I might do as well is use this colour on the hair. Okay. So for the water bottle, I'm going to use Vallejo Dark Rust. So now on the collar and cuffs, they're going to be red. So we're using Vallejo Red. Quite aptly named, really. So next I'm going to use Vallejo Light Grey. That's going to be for the turnbacks, lapels and straps. There Again, apologies for the focus. It's on autofocus. Hopefully it's not making you feel a bit ill. If anyone's painting along right now, feel free to let me know what you're painting at the moment. So we're going to go for a nice green pom-pom. I'm going to use Vallejo Black Green. Missed a bit of his sideburn. Did one side but not the other. There we go. Bit of the turn back there as well, just visible. Those pesky straps. It can be quite easy to miss those in all the little crevices of the figure. See, there's a little bit there right behind the water bottle strap, just behind the rope there. Okay, starting to come together. starting to come to life. Let's see. I'm going to give him a quick dry off, so I'm going to mute my microphone for a second. Okay, we're unmuted now. Now the figure's dry, I can wash over the flesh. We have a Games Workshop Agrax Earth Shade. Very versatile wash this. Little shake, put it on one of these little hockey puck things. Stop it from spilling over. The amount of times we've spilt one of these, and it's not the cheapest either, so get yourself one of those if you can. They're very, very good. So I'm going to go over the hair as well as the flesh and the backpack. I'm just going to add some easy shading to those particular parts. Okay, whilst that's drying, we're going to start highlighting the other colours. So for the blue, I'm going to use Scale 75 Cantabric Blue. This is going on top of Deep Blue. So I'm using a free zero brush at the moment. It's a Kalinske Sable. Little bit on the cuff flap. I really wish it would focus better. lovely and matte, the Scale 75 paints. Very, very nice. So the trousers, I'm going to highlight with Vallejo beige. Okay, I think I'll probably do for the first highlight on the trousers. Now for the shako cover, I'm going to use Vallejo khaki. This is going on top of Vallejo dark mud. Now the blanket roll, If you joined us from the start, you may have noticed it was pre-undercoated. I'm pretty sure it was done in Vallejo Dark Grey. So we're going to go over that first highlight of Vallejo Neutral Grey. So when you're painting a blanket roll like this, it's quite important that you pay attention on the sides, which way round the spiral, like which way the blanket roll has been rolled. You can usually tell, it's quite subtle sometimes, but yeah, you can tell, and you want to follow the spiral as much as you can and join that up. Bit like that. Then make sure it's the same on both sides, otherwise it might look a bit silly. Okay, cool. So now the wood on the gun, we're going to give that a quick highlight with Vallejo Beige Brown. That's going on top of Vallejo Flat Brown. We've already got some squeezed out actually, so I'm just going to use that, alter that down slightly. Alright, so now the water bottle. I need a paint called Leather. Here we go. This is going on top of Vallejo Dark Rust. All right, so let's do the first highlight on the flesh. So we actually base coated the flesh in flesh base, and then we gave it a wash with the Games Workshop Agrax Earthshade. So now that's dry, we can go back over it with the flesh base. Not fully, we're just going to go over the, you know, the raised areas, pick out the bits we want to highlight. Don't forget the ears. Right, the backpack, we're going to give a highlight with Vallejo brown sand. It's quite light, so we're not going to go crazy. We're going to do some fine lines. We used a Vallejo beige brown with Agrax for the base coat. So I'm going to start by picking out the edges. So where the top flap folds over, and then on the sides there's a little horizontal line. And also we're just going to continue this around on both sides. This helps give some sort of definition. And then once you've done that, you can put some vertical lines just to give it some better, pick out some of the texture. Okay, not looking too bad. So with the black, I'm going to highlight it with Scale 75 called Abyssal Blue. It's kind of a bluish grey, really. does what it says on the tin. So when you're painting the peak of the shako, check underneath to see if you've got any flesh underneath there, and then you can tidy that up. Same on the neck. All right, now we're going to highlight the blue again. And for this, I'm using scale color Caspian blue. It looks pretty light, but if we use it sort of sparingly and only pick out the bits we want to pick out, it won't overpower the mid color. Hi Stephen, thanks for the comment. Appreciate you watching. Alright, now we've finished with the blue, we're going to go on to the trousers. And we're going to use Vallejo Ivory. This is going on top of beige brown. Just beige. And underneath that was light mud. So there's a nice triad that we're using. Okay, I think that's done with the trousers there. Next, the shako cover. So we did use dark mud and khaki. That was the base coat and the first highlight. And now we're going to use light mud. So that's another nice triad right there. Already got a little bit squeezed out, so we're just going to water that down a smidge. Oh, it's actually, that's dried up quite a bit, so we'll pour a little bit more out. Okay, that's the shako cover. We're going to add a quick highlight to the blanket roll now. For this colour, I'm using Vallejo Light Grey. Cool, that's done. Okay, not much more to finish it off now. I'm just going to add a second highlight to the flesh. For that, I'm going to use Vallejo Flat Flesh. It's going on top of Flesh Base, which we washed with Games Workshop Agrax Earthshade. Do my best to keep it in focus. Okay, that'll do. So the pom-pom, we're going to give it a nice dotty highlight with German camo bright green. Now the base coat is quite a lot darker than this, so this should show up quite a bit. But because we're doing it nice and dotty, it should give it a nice sort of bit of a texture to it, which would be cool. So now we're going to do the red, highlight the red collar and cuffs with Vallejo Dark Vermilion. So at the same time as highlighting those, we can do a bit of piping on the lapels and turnbacks. And also a bit of piping to the outside edge of the cuff flap and along the top. Made the piping a little thick on the turn back there, but because we've not highlighted it yet, we can tidy that up when we highlight the white on the turn back. I think the shoulder straps are piped in red as well. Okay, that's cool. So now I'm going to take just pure white. White or off-white is a good choice. Either's fine. Actually, I didn't do any piping on the lapels, but you can't really see it. He's covered them up pretty well with his arms. Perhaps around the button there. We can just put a bit of red. And then the other side will just be a strap. So now we've got some white squeezed out. We can highlight the straps. Hi Plastic Monkey, thanks for the comment. Welcome to the stream. if you are just joining us, this is a bit of a test stream for us. We've not streamed in quite a while. So you will notice that the camera focus is going in and out a bit. Hopefully we can rectify that the next time. But yeah, thanks for joining us, and hopefully you're painting along. Okay, I think that's all the straps highlighted. Need to do a little bit of piping on the collar and cuffs. Okay, right, so to finish this off, we're going to do the water bottle rope strap. I'm not quite sure what colour I want to do that. I think I might just do it sort of a green ochre colour. So I've got this colour here called British Tank Crew. This is quite nice. Got a bit of a greenish tinge to it. Should contrast quite nicely with the rest of the figure. Hi Nick Studio, thanks for joining us. Okay, so now I want to paint the gold. There is one single button on the lapel, and the lapel is white at the moment. So before I paint that button, I'm going to darken that down with a brown. I'm just going to use germ camo black brown. Actually, the same on the buckles on the straps at the back here. And whilst I'm back here, actually, this strap here is looking a little messy. It's a little gone over the edge slightly. So I'm just going to use some of the abyssal blue just to tidy that up a smidge. Now the gunmetal, I'm going to use a game air colour. These are really designed for airbrush usage, but they're also quite good for brushwork as well. They're not thick, they're obviously designed to flow a lot better, so I quite like that with my metallics. I find that some of the normal ones can be a bit thick. And for the gold, I'm going to use Games Workshop Retributor Armor. So you notice the brown undercoat just makes that button stand out just a little bit more than it would if you just put the gold straight over the light grey and white. So that's pretty nice. So nearly done now. Just going to take bit more abyssal blue just to tidy up this visor, not all, you know, the peak of the cap. There we go. And this bit of the trouser there. And a nice touch is I like to have my bayonets a brighter silver. So I'm going to use Game Air Silver over the top of that as a little highlight. Just a little flick on both sides will do. Okay, so there we have the finished figure. I'm not going to put eyes in it because I'm still a bit rusty behind the camera. I think I might need to practice a bit there. Normally I would do the eyes first anyway before I highlight the face, so maybe we'll try that next time. So I hope you enjoyed the live stream, hope you enjoyed watching and learnt something. Hopefully the focus isn't too annoying. But it's pretty cool being back. Thanks for the comments, thanks for the likes. And if you haven't subscribed, that would be nice if you did. Leave a subscribe and catch me on the next video. So again, thanks for watching and I will see you next time.